Okay, what's up? We are live. Hello, everybody. This is Daniel Barrett here from AdWords Nerds. Hello, wonderful people. I'm making this video because there's, you know, I've been having a lot of conversations with real estate investors kind of behind the scenes. You know, recently, I went out to a big mastermind out in Florida. I got to talk to a lot of really advanced kind of high level investors. And I wanted to kind of bring a bunch of things together because right now in the real estate investing world, there are a ton of very kind of serious seismic changes in the marketplace. And I think if you are getting into real estate investing or you've been in real estate investing for a long time, you have to deal with some extremely serious changes. And I'm going to try in this video kind of lay these out the way that I see them because I think many people are kind of aware of some of them, but they're not aware of necessarily how these all interact. So the first one that I want to talk about is, of course, the entrance of iBuyers into the real estate investing space. And these are websites like Zillow, or they have Zillow Instant Offers. You've got companies like Opendoor. You've got companies like OfferPad. Now, these are, in many cases, venture-backed firms that are spending billions of dollars in marketing and acquisitions cost, and they are gobbling up kind of like every ugly house they can get their hands on. I mean, Zillow is right now on pace to do about 5,000 flips a month, which is essentially like building a small town every single month. And that is incredibly destabilizing to the traditional kind of ugly house buyer market. And the thing you have to remember about these companies is they don't care about making money, right? Their goal right now is not to make a profit. So that is a very serious destabilizing force that I think every investor needs to think about. And the second thing is that some of the traditional sources of deals for real estate investors, so that's like REOs, we're talking about short sales, talking about foreclosures, these are getting harder and harder to find. And this is because basically hedge funds and big real estate players are going after this kind of off-market property, and they are fighting it out. And they're fighting it out with the existing kind of universe of real estate investors. So for many of these properties, what's happening is even when they're available, there's this really intense kind of bidding war effect where everybody's bidding each other up and the prices are getting higher and higher. And that's kind of this like vicious cycle where there's harder to find the deals and then the deals are harder to make a profit on. So the sort of traditional real estate deal sources are getting sort of pretty intense in terms of competition. Now, as if those things weren't enough, because we have these sort of like big institutional players that are destabilizing that part of the market, in the kind of like retail real estate investor space or like sort of real estate investing educational space, there are more and more real estate investors jumping into the market. You have the success of like the HGTV sort of part of the universe where everybody thinks they can flip. And so more and more new people are coming into the kind of like the traditional wholesaling or rehabbing market. You can see this actually, if you look at Google search data, you look at Google Trends, the term real estate investing is at an all-time high, meaning literally there are more people searching for how to become a real estate investor and real estate investor information than at any point in human history, right? So there are not only more institutional players spending a ton of money, there are more mom and pop sort of newbie players entering the market. And then on top of that, housing prices are going up. So I don't know if you've been tracking kind of like housing price information, but the actual properties are more valuable now, and that seems on trend to continue. And so what you have is like all these different forces, right, combining to make it harder and harder for the average investor to find discounted deals, the sort of bread and butter of this sort of traditional real estate investor business. And when you do find those deals, there is less and less meat on that bone. And so it's harder to find the profit margin that real estate investors have traditionally relied on to wholesale or flip or whatever. So basically, we're in a marketplace right now where off-market deals are getting incredibly hard to find and the profit margins are smaller and smaller. And I'm going to tell you that the real estate investors that are going to be in business 5 years, 10 years, 20 years from now, They are going to be the investors that realize that those changes in the marketplace are happening, that those changes in the marketplace are not going anywhere anytime soon, and they adapt to those changes, right? You just can't have... It's not the kind of business where it used to be 10 years ago where you could just send out some direct mail and get, you know, 5-10 deals a month. That universe doesn't exist anymore. And I'm telling you that as a real estate investor, you need to realize and adapt to those changes. Knowledge is power, right? But action is needs to be on top of that knowledge in order to actually capitalize on it. So let me know if you have any questions. Feel free to comment, like on this video or whatever. Let me know what you think. And yeah, I'll be talking to you very soon.